The bullet that killed Trooper Ritchie hit him just above the body armor vest he was wearing. But as Team 4 investigative reporter Jim Parsons shows us, even had that bullet struck the vest, the armor probably would not have saved him.
You've heard the term, and you hear it often, bulletproof vest. Fact of the matter is, most of these are not bulletproof. They're bullet resistant.
This isn't going to stop every type of ammunition out there. It's only designed to cover a certain range.
At the Lenape Vo-Tech School today in Ford City, these high school-age students in the law enforcement program were mindful of what happened in Venango County on Wednesday, and so they wanted to talk about body armor and domestic calls for patrol officers.
You're coming in, they're way up here on that emotional scale, aren't they? They're upset. I mean, they're very upset.
As it happens, these future officers are preparing to take part this evening in a service marking the 30th anniversary of the murder of Apollo police officer Leonard Miller. Miller was gunned down by Michael Travaglia and John Lesko in a series of slayings known as the Kill for Thrill homicides. 30 years later, the lessons are still being learned.
You said it depends on, like, the caliber of the bullet.
Sure.
It depends on the range, too. They were right up against you.
Instructor Jason Gursky is a 10-year veteran of the Apollo Police Department and an expert on body armor. He says Trooper Paul Ritchie had no chance of surviving a round from a high-powered hunting rifle, even if it had struck him in the vest.
It would just be devastating. You're talking about a projectile traveling, you know, 1,500, 1,900, 2,000 feet per second, a lot of muzzle energy. It's going to go right through the vest.
So there really isn't a practical body armor situation that's going to save a police officer's life who's shot with a high-powered rifle. But for most situations with a handgun, body armor can be the difference between life and death. In Ford City, Jim Parsons, Channel 4 Action News.